Howe.
Hi, adventurers. I have three quick tips on how to learn how to sail for free.
I usually do my weekly vlog about how the week was, but I kind of experienced a bit of trauma on the weekend and I'm still moving through it. So to get to the PTG, post-traumatic growth, until I want to share about that, which will probably be next week, I want to share with you this.
I have one tip for your mind, one for your body, and one for your soul, because that's just how I roll. So number one is go to the library and get some books. Libraries are such an untapped resource. They may not even have the exact book you want, but there will definitely be a selection on sailing, of adventures, of biographies of sailors. I literally got this book, Sailing for Dummies. Like, how much simpler do you want to go? And I would just read through it all the time. I would just do a couple of pages at a time. And the reason why this is really good is because there's a whole nother language, a whole nother lingo when it comes to sailing. Whether it's the parts of the sail, whether it's the sides of the boat, whether it's different cardinals, there's just a whole nother language to it, which is really beautiful once you become fluent in it. But if you're to get on a boat and you don't understand what they're talking about, it's going to be hella confusing. So it's really nice just to know your starboard from your port, to know your jib to your mainsail, to know that ropes are called sheets when they're attached to the sails. So books and reading can be a really good way on how to kind of start integrating some of that language and understanding and learnings into your book, into your life. So that's for your mind. So get out there and get some books from the library. You can join for free and then you can usually get a whole bunch of them. And sometimes they can even do it so that they can get books from other libraries as well. That's just in Australia. What's it like where you are? Number two, my tip for supporting your body and learning how to sail is to get on sailboats. Obviously, no. But how do you do that for free, team? I don't have a boat. I don't have one yet either. That's what I'm working towards. Well, the way that I have done it is a few ways. So there's these whole websites that are designed basically to connect people with boats. So I'll put the link in the description below. If you have a boat and you're looking for a crew or vice versa, all around the world. A lot of it can be in exchange. If you want a crew on the boat in exchange for, say, going to these places or getting fed, then that's the transaction, shall we say. So you get to learn so much while also supporting them and helping them out. A really good way though of navigating this is becoming really clear with what you are available for and getting really good about the questions that you want to ask people who say have boats or ask people who are crewing. It's the same way if you've ever lived in a share house. You want to make sure that you're asking questions to know that you're actually compatible as far as being crew and having like a skipper. I have only learned this through trial and error though. There are many boats that I've been on that I've learned a lot from and from people that I've crewed with. I've kind of learned the style that I kind of like and I've learned how to communicate that to other people. So another way as well is to boat deliveries. So I would often help crewing on people who were delivering boats like up and down the East Coast. They would usually pay for my flights or my accommodation in exchange for helping crew the boat. The only thing that's different with this is it's usually like a speed is a thing. So you're kind of trying to get from A to B as fast as possible. So you often don't get to like hang out at the beach and just really relax the destinations that you're going through. Just become really clear whether it's the actual sailing activity that you're trying to learn more of or whether it's the lifestyle that you're trying to learn more of. Great resources online and just start asking around as well. My other tip is at the marina. I was lucky enough to be close to one of the largest marinas in the Southern Hemisphere, and on Wednesdays they would have WAGs, which was traditionally Wednesday afternoon gentlemen sailing. But because we're getting a little bit modernized now and there's women who also like to sail, it's called Wednesday Afternoon Go Sailing. And it's often a little bit of a regatta that goes for a couple of hours and people allow other people to come on their boats and sail around the race with them. It's all for fun. And that can get you a bit more familiar with being on a boat, especially in a different context, like racing compared to cruising. And that's usually free. So the best way is just to call up your local marina and ask if they do have any activities where people can come and crew and have a play, basically. So have a little call, have a little Google. There's definitely stuff out there. And number three, my tip for your soul in learning how to sail is start to become really present and start to witness your environment more. So this can be watching the weather, noticing what clouds are in the sky. Is it changing? Where is the wind coming from? What is the tide doing? Is it going in? Is it going out? Are we at a full moon? Will it be a king tide? Are we at a new moon? Is there heat that's generating over the next couple of days, bringing like a high or a low pressure? So just starting to notice your environment. That's one thing that's become really apparent to me, is just how tuned in to our senses I need to become when I'm sailing, because all of my senses are picking up information that is absolutely needed when we're sailing. So when I notice that the breeze has changed, I'm gonna need to change my sails. When I'm noticing that the pressure is dropping and the temperature is changing, I'm noticing for a difference in storms or clouds. When I'm noticing that something doesn't quite feel right on the boat, whether I'm like at the helm and something feels off, there might be something wrong with, say, with the rudder or with the steering component. So when I become tuned in, I become quite intuitive and I move as one with the boat and with my environment around me. Another fun way of doing that is when you go to the ocean or you go out in nature, start looking for the animals. Start being quiet, listening, tuning in, and start to notice where the animals are, what they're doing, what sounds they're making. So we really want to tune in to that sight, sound, taste, feeling. What's the other one? And sensing. So really becoming activated with the six senses. And that helps build your gut instinct as well, because I believe that sailing is really quite intuitive. So the more you can become in tune with yourself, the more empowered of a sailor you're going to be. Those are my three tips for this week. I'm sure I'll be back next week with a vlog. Make sure you like and subscribe to continue the journey, because it really does support me in doing something that I love, which hopefully encourages you to do something that you love. Go well.